Cat's eye, little ghost, ghost of Jupiter, bow tie, lemon slice, butterfly and skull. These nebulae, I've seen them all, but I've never witnessed anything like this before. The central tri-star system pulses like a heart. Nothing unusual there, but the interstellar cloud formations around it are becoming energized. No, conduits. They're directing some form of energy being created by the core. But that's not possible. Any energy should be dispersed evenly. There, that planetary alignment. There on the cusp, that must be the key. It's drawing that energy, whatever it is, and acting like a relay. Now the clouds are in retrograde as the planetary system is expanding, projecting. Where? This energy is unknown, but clearly has a powerful influence over space-time itself. And it's being emitted directly into space, like a laser beam or a bolt of lightning. If it should come into contact with an inhabited planet... Wait. There, Rhizoma Minor. It was populated millennia ago, but the ancient civilization has long since died out. There's only wildlife amongst the ruins of their cities now. It's on the outer edge of the affected region, but if that beam of energy hits, all life on the planet could be transformed, mutated, defiled, destroyed. I need to take a closer look and see if I need to redirect this burst of energy. Who knows what conditions may be like down there now. That, the countryside itself's a bit odd. These trees should be tall and straight, not twisted and coiled like baby fern leaves. The foliage should be green in this hemisphere too, not these shades of purple. The air is cold too, and yet, there, towards the horizon, the air is rippling like a mirage in the desert. Whoa! Even the ground here is rippling. No, the stone here is rising like waves of tiny stalagmites. It's as if the matter's been turned into a fluid through vibration and drawn up into the air, like liquid on a speaker or millions of tentacles bouncing and writhing in unison. These ripples seem to be coming from beyond the ruins ahead. Is that what remains of the Rhizoman Kingdom? A once great city reduced to a collection of dilapidated stone walls? Overrun with, well, what was greenery but now magenta flora, wrapping itself around the ruins. Those creatures there, I suppose you could call them deer, but look closer! That one's neck is elongated. Elongating. They're being affected too. Before my eyes, legs stretching into gangly stilts, eyes bulging and fluctuating in colour, their tongues whipping out and dripping with fluorescent saliva. Those poor beasts. I have to get to the bottom of this. The vibrations are rippling out in pulses from over there in the derelict city. Derelict except for that one building there. Is that a temple? A temple to what? Is that somehow behind this? Well, one way to find out. Legs, do your job before you go the same way as the deers. Although, maybe I'd look good as a daddy long legs. These ancient ruins, it must have been a thriving city. Millennia ago. I wonder what the culture was like. The Rhizomans had a reputation as being spiritual, but beyond the priest caste, what were the general population like? A city this big, they must have been advanced to maintain it, but they remain a mystery. What happened here? Natural disaster? Environmental crisis? Did they wipe themselves out in some stupid war? Worrying how common that is. I walk these same streets when maybe children would run and play. Perhaps that building there used to be a school. This here looks like it could have been a town square. Maybe it was a market, where the townsfolk could gather, not just to buy and sell goods, but to chat, to socialise and exchange gossip. Maybe they had festivals in the street, wedding parties, the bride and groom being escorted through the streets by the wedding guests, being cheered on by onlookers. And then, of course, funeral processions, leading those departed through the streets so that everyone can pay their respects and send them off. Such is the way of life. And now they're all gone. I could go back and have a look. Jump in that blue box of mine. Where is it? Ah, there in the distance. Like an ancient monolith that's always stood on the stone outcropping that amaranth field. It looks just like... Look at that quake! It's bigger than the rest by far. It's still going. You can see where its shockwave is moving down the hillside, knocking down buildings like dominoes as it goes. There! It's at the edge of the ruins. A great crack in the ground shooting out into the fields towards the TARDIS! No! It's fallen into the crack! The ground just splits open beneath it and swallowed it whole. It's gone! No. I have to find a way to get it back, to reverse what's happening to the planet. Okay, that temple's at the center of this. Time to take a closer look. The temple structure is being twisted and distorted. It's hard to tell its original shape. Like the stone outcrop before, the whole building is being pulled upwards, stretching as though reaching for the energy that's falling from space. The boundary walls still have the remains of metal gates outside, but like the rest of the building, they're being pulled upon and deformed by the giant fangs of some terror from the deepest oceans guarding the entrance. Must be some strong ally to have survived all these years, though. I wonder. No, too much interference from the cosmic rays. The sonic screwdriver isn't able to get a reading. Looks like I'll have to eyeball it from here. I'll have to resolve this fast. I can feel the energy having an increased effect on me. My hand just then, as I opened the gate, tingled like a mild electric shock before I touched it. Like I'm feeling beyond the reach of my physical body. I fear that's the silence I'm being pulled upon and misshapen like the gates, like the animals, like everything I've seen here. Not just the deer-like creatures in the fields, but the birds in the sky with long ribbon-like tails trailing behind them as they spiral upwards. Above the temple as though caught in a vortex. Back in the city too, animals that looked like the descendants of domestic pets like cats and dogs, staring at me with bulbous, luminous eyes and long tongues whipping out in front of their faces. Is that to be my fate too? I mean, I've had bulbous eyes before, that's not too bad, but the whipping tongue? Handy for eating ice cream, I suppose, but not entirely flattering unless you're a homo reptilian. No, I need to find a way to put an end to this before all life on the planet, myself included, has been stretched and mangled and reformed into what? Well, hopefully we'll never find out. Okay, into the mouth of the anglerfish I go. I just hope I have the same look as Jonah. It's dark inside the temple, but I can make out enough that I don't want to touch the walls. There's a strange organic matter growing up there like moss, but it's fleshy and warm to the touch, like the wall itself is becoming organic and these corridors are forming a giant vascular structure, and I'm walking down an oversized artery. Or esophagus. I have to be careful, the floor's getting slippery now. I think the moisture's coming off the walls. Not condensation, but actually being secreted, like thousands of saliva glands are dribbling away to keep an enormous tongue moist. The air is humid too, and that smell, it's like raw sausage meat. No, more like a dirty butcher's shop that needs a good scrub. Is that what this puddle is? Runoff from a rancid butcher's slab trickling underfoot. The corridor opens up into a larger chamber here. The fleshy moss has completely coated the interior. It's like being inside a giant stomach, complete with purple veins running up the inside of the semi-translucent skin. Wait, there are figures moving around in here. They seem to be focused on what they're doing. They haven't paid any attention to me, but I'd better stick to the shadows nonetheless. They seem to be dressed in rags, literally strips of material hanging down from them like bandages on cartoon mummies. Oh, they're trailing in the pus and ooze on the floor as they walk around in circles. They're almost choreographed, although none of them seem to be speaking to each other, so they must have been well rehearsed. But for what purpose? Some kind of folk dance? In a giant stomach? Yeah, good one, Doctor. A ritual, maybe. That one seems to be the leader, the high priest, as it were. Or priestess. It's hard to tell, they're all so tall and elongated. They're like androgynous shop dummies. Ooh, the mummies are dummies. The mummies are dummies in a big tummy. Okay, I'll stop that now. It's not funny. The leader, they're raising their long arms in the air as though beckoning something down from the heavens. The others continue their slow dance around them. Look how they all gesture to the air, then down to the ground. It's almost like they're signalling something above them to land at their feet, or drawing the energy down from the cosmos. What's that? They've stopped moving around and they're shaking their hands in the air. Are they celebrating? That sounds like a happy... Did they do that? Is that what they're doing here? Have they brought some kind of life form into the world? Why would they go to such extreme lengths, and what kind of creature requires this kind of ritual and cosmic energy to birth it? This passage is a tight fit. It's taking all my effort to squeeze along in all this mucousy fluid. It's like trying to crawl along a sleeping giant's gullet. A sleeping giant with a cold. Must find the source of that heartbeat, though. I need to determine if it's a threat or... Where am I now? Seems to be a large open chamber, lit up by some kind of bioluminosity in the walls. But what's that hanging up above? Look how it's like a massive spider egg sack, dangling there, wrapped in silk. But inside you can see it's one large mass, not hundreds of eggs. And it's moving, pulsating. Is that the source of the heartbeat? Is it alive or just a clump of organic matter? I wonder. Yes, if I concentrate, I can sense it has a psychic signature, but its energy goes beyond this cluster of cells. It radiates out into the cosmos. Careful, Doctor. I can feel a temptation to ride the wave of psychic energy wherever it pulls me. Right out to the space anomaly, I should imagine. I need to focus. If I can make a connection to it, the thing in this room, I might be able to read its thoughts, or at least its intentions. Does it mean harm to this world? Here goes. Concentrate. Its mind is definitely connected to the cosmic phenomenon. It's alien. Well, everything's alien on another planet, but this is different. Like, it's not of this world, this universe. It feels like it's falling, like it should be living in a bathtub and someone's pulled out the plug. Like it's been pulled down the drain and flung out into space. I'm floating in space. I'm all alone and floating in space. No, falling. I'm falling through space. Plummeting. The stars rush past as my speed increases. It's all stretching out into a blur in front and blackness behind me. But there's something there in the blackness. Something is chasing me. I can feel it. I must escape. I have to escape. I can sense it. If I don't get away, I'll be wiped from existence. I cannot allow myself to be condemned to oblivion. I'm falling through space at an impossible speed, being pursued by an unseen predator. This form I'm in is transient, ethereal, delicate. If I'm to survive, I must take a corporeal form, become physical and grow in strength. That's all, submit and descend into the blackness and be erased. And so I slipped for aeons, waiting for the right conditions to spawn my seed and manifesting tremendous energy to grow it and transfer my consciousness. But it's not quite ready yet. I must wait a while longer, and yet I remain tethered and vulnerable. Vulnerable to the things in the darkness. The unseen dangers lurking in the shadows. Am I dreaming? Is this a creature's mind? I can't tell what's real. What are my thoughts and what are the creatures? I feel like I'm in its mind, like this is a construct, and yet I can see it all so clearly. The stars streaking past me as I continue to increase in velocity, but also the planets in the distance, Arizona Minor. I'm in both places at once. It's more than that, though. I'm not just seeing the planets like I'm standing on this surface, but it's like I'm flying through the air, swimming in the ocean, and hovering above it in orbit, all at once. It's like the planet itself has a mind and is observing itself. I am the planet. The planet is the consciousness hurtling through the cosmos, and yet so is the creature in the cavern. The creatures. There's a powerful psychic presence out in the depths of space. The anomaly created it, or it created the anomaly. Of that I'm sure. The two are linked. It's all interlinked. One mind, one being. Symbiosis. And I'm witnessing its birth or rebirth. It seems all so very, very old. It's an ancient being. That's been... I thought it felt familiar, and that's why. It's like cells transmutating, that tingling sensation of rejuvenation. But unless I leave now, I'm going to be swept up and rejuvenated along with it, and I'm not quite ready for that again just yet. Whoa, that was intense. All around me, this This fleshy substance, I see now, is a byproduct, like chrysalis meconium. The whole world is being reshaped and reformed, and this primitive matter, like primordial ooze, is just residual goop, like setting skin on custard. Oh, I like custard skin. Maybe I'll have a nice bit of spotted dick and custard when I get back to the TARDIS. Wait! The TARDIS! It fell down a crack during the quake. I need to find a way to retrieve it. Maybe those mummies could help. They seem to be working with the entity to bring life back to the world. Part of the symbiosis. Maybe they're connected to it somehow, like I just was. That's why they don't need to speak. They're all part of the same psychic network. If I can communicate with them, maybe they can act as a relay so that I can talk directly to the entity. Up here, look, the bioluminescence grows stronger in the walls. That has to be a sign of activity. Yes, more of the mummy creatures. Wait, they're climbing out of the walls, literally, tearing holes in the flesh from the other side. But what's up beyond? Oh, I see. The chambers they're emerging from, those are coming to the same reshaping process as the rest of the planet, you can see there's some kind of stasis pods. These mummies must be part of the original Rhizoma minor population. Some kind of priest or engineer caste, perhaps. Workers in the anthill. They must have been kept down here, dormant, until conditions were right to begin the process of regeneration. Oh, hello, are you stuck? Here, let me give you a hand. Up you get. I can see you're new here, but I wonder if you could help me find my way out. Yes, you can touch my face if you... Oh, I see, it's a psychic link. You're probing my mind, my memories, to understand what I'm asking. Okay, I'll let you see a little bit. It's a strange sensation, like when you stand from a chair too fast and the blood leaves your head, kind of dizzy and tingly at the same time. Oh, it's like I'm in two places at once again. Is this how you guys see the world? A true hive mind, existing as a multifaceted consciousness. It's remarkable, I can see the path out of here, and the magenta meadow beyond the city at the same time, and... I can't tell if you're showing me what's happening or what you intend, but I can feel it. My TARDIS is rising to the surface. Thank you! Thank you, my friend! Friends! Now, I can tell you're on the brink, but if you could just hold off the final stage of your rejuvenation while I get back there, and I'll be out of your way. Really, though, I'd better hurry. I can feel it building up like a volcano ready to blow, and I'm gonna get caught in the blast. To the catacombs, but the air is hardly any fresher up here. Not pungent or unpleasant smelling, but humid and stifling, like being in the kitchen on a hot day with cooking oil in the air, clinging to your skin. I need to hurry. It's getting close now, like static electricity building up in the air, ready to discharge. It's hard to keep a footing. The floor keeps crumbling underfoot, breaking into stones that float into the air. Even the buildings, these ancient walls, they're crumbling too. But the bricks and debris, they don't just fall to the floor there. They float off, like bubbles in the air. Then plants grow on them, trees even. It's happening all around, creating a forest in the air. It's like being in one of those old cartoons where the animators get carried away and just let their imaginations run wild. Look at the stray cat-like creature chasing the mousy things over there. Watch how it pounces, only for its prey to burst, like balloons and colourful spores spill out. Look how flower patches grow in their place. Ha! As a stray cat emerges, see how the petals break off and fly away like butterflies. Here, see how these old tree stumps sway in unison, like they're dancing to some unheard tune. Oh, there, do you see that hole in the ground? Give it a moment and there! Those two rocks keep rising out of it, as though carried up in hot air currents, swirling around each other. Look closer now. They have roots attached that reach out like tiny tentacles, trying to hold on to their partner before they drop back down into the hole again. So much to see, but there's no time to spare. The scarlet field is ahead where the TARDIS awaits. There, it's about to begin. The final stages before everything is absorbed and reformed, including me. Just in time. Look at you, Rhizoma Minor. If I just arrived, I would think it was chaos here. The sky as red as blood. Rivers of rock streaming across the sky, spontaneously sprouting clouds of forests. Herds of bovine-like pachyderms stampede across and transform into a murmuration of birds. Or are they bats? animal, vegetable and mineral, animated and malleable. But I've shared your mind. I know this is part of your natural cycle. Life grows, fades, and lays dormant. Then, when the conditions are right for life again, you reawaken, revitalized. The whole world living as one organism. I feel blessed to have witnessed your regeneration cycle.